Hello, welcome to Yoga with Katie. Today we're going to be using the latex band for some exercises, and we'll continue to work on the core and the legs. So we're going to come to a comfortable seat position, sitting about two-thirds of the way in your chair. Shoulders are relaxed, stomach and chest proud. If you like, you can close your eyes for a moment, taking a few calming breaths. Inhale deeply through your nose and exhale through your nose as well. Couple more breaths. And we're gonna slowly open up the eyes, wiggling your fingers and your toes. Wrist and ankle rotation. Go the other way. We're gonna inhale the arms up above the head, point your toes. Big, big stretch. Exhale and down by your side. One more time, inhale your arms up above the head, point your toes. Rib cage rising, elongate the body. Exhale and down by your side. Take a breath here. Stretching out the neck next, ear to shoulder, extend the opposite arm out. Using the same hand to guide support the head. Lengthening, stretch. One more breath, we're gonna slowly come back to center and the other side. Ear to shoulder, extend the opposite arm out. Using the same hand, guide or support the head. Lengthening, stretch. Release any tension that you may have. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Inhale, right arm up, bring it across your chest, supported by the other hand. Pull back, creating resistance. When I face you, I do mirror image. Slowly release, same arm up, release and place the palm behind your back and use the other hand to guide the elbow, tricep stretch, chin up, eyes looking forward. If you can bind hands behind your back, go ahead. Slowly release, shake it out, the other side, arm up and across, pull back. Shoulder stretch, creating resistance. And slowly release, same arm up, lengthen. Place the palm behind your back. Use the other hand to guide the elbow, tricep stretch. If you can bind hands behind your back, go ahead, binding hands behind you. One more breath, and we're gonna slowly release, shake it out, hands on the shoulders, elbows in, elbows out. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Feel the pinch in your shoulder blades, opening up the lung, heart, chest. And we're gonna slowly, slowly release. We're gonna inhale the arms open, chin up, head back, stimulating thyroid gland. Exhale to close. So we're gonna do it a few times. Inhale to open up lung, heart, chest. Feel the pinch in shoulder blade. Exhale to close, chin to chest. Two more times. Inhale to open. Exhale to close. One last one. Inhale to open. Exhale to close. So we come back to center. Now we're gonna talk about these bands. So in my kit, there are five different ones. So I have a light green one, which is, it says so here, extra light. So extra light is about 10 to 15 pounds. And when you pull it, you feel like, this is easy. So we're gonna move to the next level. For the blue one, it says light. So light is for 12 to 17 pounds. So getting a little bit tougher, but still manageable. Next one, it says medium, is yellow. Yellow is about 17 to 25 pounds. So once again, getting a little bit are difficult. Next one up is rep heavy for 25 to 35 pounds. So this one, I don't think I can move very much with it. And the last but not least is extra heavy black 35 to 45. So this one is really, really tough. So you pick the level that you want to work on. I would say the extra light might be too easy. So we can go between the light and the medium. So for this particular demonstration, I'm going to pick up my yellow band, which is medium. So bring it around your wrist. Arms up, palms facing each other. And palm and squeeze. Now, if this is too much for you, go back down one level, which is light. And that's the blue one, if you have the same set as mine. So keep pausing it, open, shut here. Four, five, four, three, two, one. Slowly release, arm down first, shake it out, release tension. So just now we had palm facing each other, and now we're gonna have palm facing out. Arms up above the head. At any time you want to stop, take a break, go ahead. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. You can really feel the burn. So we're gonna come down and do a few rounds of shoulder rotation, release any tension that you may have, and then gonna go to the chest level. So I'm gonna continue with my yellow. So chest level, tuck the elbows in, palm facing each other. So we're just using different tools to condition the muscles. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Slowly release, come down, catch your breath. And then we're gonna shoot the arrow. So I'm gonna loop the end through my thumb and I'm gonna pull it. So the medium one is manageable. You can still feel that you're challenged. If this is too much for you, go down one level to the blue. So it depends on what latex band that you have. You find the one that is suitable for you. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Slowly release. Take a breath here and go to the other side. Shoot the arrow, pull back. Arms at shoulder height. Let's do another five, four, three, two. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Let's do shoulder roll here. And reverse. And we're going to try to bring it behind our head. And pull it up. Now make sure you have secure the band. It's not going to snap on you. But over time, through wear and tear, they do break. do another five. Four. Three. Two. One. Slowly release. Switching side. And when you're ready, you can begin. Chin is away from the body, looking up. Secure on one foot. I'm sitting further out in my chair and I'm gonna palm it up. Five. Four. Three, two, one, slowly release, switching side. Anchor yourself and then you can pull it up. Five, four, three, two, one. Slowly, slowly release. Bring it to the chest level. Just gonna open. I know the medium one is a little bit hard. Just wanna show you if I use the lightest one, I can open up a little bit more. So it depends on your level and your workout. I can still feel a lot of resistance here, even if I'm using the lightest one. Five, four, three, two, one. Slowly, slowly release. Go back to yellow and I'm gonna loop it through my legs to the thigh area. Open, shut. Now even with the medium weights, I still feel that this is kind of easy. So if you want to step it up, you can use the heavy one. Just do another set here. Sitting up nice and tall. Shoulders on top of hips, stomach and chest proud. Chin is away from the body, eyes looking forward. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Slowly, slowly coming back to release. Now I'm gonna come stand up and continue to work on standing. So you can still have your band around the thigh area. We're gonna come to a chair pose. Legs are hip width apart, so this is hip width. Now, yellow is too much, go down one level, and if this is too easy, go up. So I'm gonna inhale up, exhale down. So I find that the yellow one is easy for me. Slightly tuck the tables in to protect your back. Don't push the knee beyond your toes. So we have the band around our thighs, so we have no choice but to engage the quadricep. Be mindful of anyone who have any shoulder issues. Cactus arm are fine. And if you have knee issues, don't go down too low. Bar stool height is fine. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Stay here. Feel the resistance. Strong arm, strong pull. Work the thigh some more. For another five, four, three, two, one. Slowly, slowly rise up. I'm gonna go behind my chair. So I'm gonna hold on to the chair for support. Adjust your bend if you find that it has slipped and slide. We're gonna inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Working on your toes, stretching out the toes. Core is strong. And because we have a band around our thighs, but we have no choice to engage, but to engage the quadricep. Now, if you want to step it up a little bit more, I'm going to pick up the blue one, which is light. So I'm going to have it around my wrist. So I'm going to inhale up, exhale down. So both arms and legs are working. Palm facing each other. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Stay up, up, up on your tippy toes for another five, four, three, two, one. Slowly, slowly come down and release. Now I'm gonna move it a little bit further down. Holding on to your chair for support. Inside leg is the standing leg. And we can also have the outside hand on your waist for support. This one is holding on to the chair. Open up the legs a little bit. So the yellow one, which is medium weight, I can feel a lot of resistance. Don't forget to breathe. Five, four, three, two, one. Slowly, slowly release. And I'm gonna do baby step to move over to the other side. Adjust your bend if necessary. Inside leg is the standing leg, holding on to your chair for support. The outside hand is on your waist. When you're ready, open up your legs. Pause it here. So the medium weight is already good enough. It's creating a lot of resistance for me. I can feel the burn. Keep going. For another five, four, three, two, one. Very good. Come down here. Catch your breath. Pedal your legs. And I'm still going to hold on to the chair. Inside leg is the standing leg. And I'm gonna take back. So I'm gonna pause it here. I'll give you a side view. Shoulders are relaxed. Engage your core abdominal muscles. Feel the burn. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly release, baby step. Go to the other side. Adjust your bend. So we're gonna walk the other leg. Make sure you're not working the same leg. Pause it here. Stretching out the hamstring. So from the hip joint to the ankle, it's all one unit. So your quadriceps should be tight. Working the calf. Point your toes up to the ceiling. If you have very tight hamstring, slightly bend the knees. And if you cannot lift the leg that high up, lower down is fine. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You also feel it in your arms as well as we hold on tight with the band. Now sit up tall, adjust your posture. If you find that you're rounding down, continue to stretch your hamstring here. Quadriceps is tight, I can feel it here, the calf. When you're ready, we're gonna open, shut. Only open to when you're comfortable. Opening up the hip joints. Feel the stretch in the inner thighs as well. Be mindful of anyone who has any hip issues. Once again, feel free to move down or move up with your latex band. If this is challenging, and always move down to the lighter bands. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly come back to center and release. Now we're gonna switch side. A little bit around your foot. Hold on tight, adjust your posture. Inhale up, exhale down. We're not kicking. Control movement. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stay up here, hold on tight. continue to feel the stretch in your hamstring, quadricep, calf, upper, as well as abdominal muscles. When you're ready, open, shut. Actually, both arms and legs are working together in this one. Stretching the thighs, opening up hip joints. Only bring the legs up to where you're comfortable. Slowly bring the legs together and release. Now we're trying to fit both feet into your strap. So maybe this one is a little bit challenging. Inhale up, exhale down. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Opening up a little bit. So I'm gonna release. I'm gonna see if I can go like this. So I think this is a better way. I think this is as much as we can open, but feel how tight it is in your quadricep, working the inner thighs. Don't forget to breathe. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Very good. Slowly release and remove the band. And we're going to do mat work. So I'm going to move my chair aside. But I'm still going to keep the bands that I need for the floor exercise. So let's come on all four, going into cat and cow. Spread all your fingers, wrists underneath the shoulder, knees underneath the hip, neutral spine. Inhale, draw up your belly, chin up, look up into a cow. Exhale, round your back as much as you can, pull your belly tight. So keep going, several more rounds. Creating spaces between vertebrates. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Connecting your breath with your movement. Cat and cow also help people to relieve back pain. And we're gonna slowly come back to neutral spine. Take an inhale in the center, exhale to overlook the right hips, squeeze the shoulder and hip together. Inhale center, exhale to the left, forming a C shape in your spine. One more set. Inhale center, exhale to the right. Inhale center, exhale to the left. Slowly, slowly come back to center, swaying side to side, release tension in your wrists. Coming into arm balance, right arm and left leg out, right thumb to the sky, back toes down, core strong, looking down, staying here, four, three, two, one, slowly release, swing side to side, and repeat on the other side, left arm and right leg out, left thumb to the sky, back toes down, lengthening. Neck and spine in one straight line. Staying here. three, two, one. Slowly, slowly release. Swing side to side. Coming into a forearm plank. Interlace the finger in front of you. Elbows within shoulders range. Coming up on your tippy toes. Shift forward hand beyond your hands. Not sticking the butt up, not sagging. We're gonna slide forward backwards. Engage your core abdominal muscles. To challenge yourself, one foot on the ground, the other foot on top. Staying here for five, four, three, two, one. Release, switching side, pop the other foot on top of the other ankle. Try your best. Staying here for five, four, three, two, one. Slowly release, come on your knees, sit back into a child pose. Sink the hip down onto the heels. If you find that you have very tight ankle or hip joint, you're not able to sit back, rest your forehead on stacked hands, stacked fists, or on your block. That would help you to sink a little bit deeper. Opening up the ankle joint. Massaging internal organs. Lengthening the spine. Massaging internal organs. Couple more breaths here. And then we're going to slowly release. We're going to come back to neutral tabletop doing some push-up. So we're going to come on our knees, cross the ankle. Doesn't matter which one is on top. Tuck the elbows, close your body. We're not flaring the elbows out. Elbows close to your body. When you're ready, let's begin for five. Try your best. Once you're done, slowly come up. Reverse the cross of your ankle. Elbows lower than the shoulders for another five. Slowly, slowly release. And we're going to come to seated. And just doing a few rounds of wrist rotation, release any tension that you may have in your wrist. Go the other way. Shake it out. Inhale, your arms up, lengthen in the center. Exhale, turn, opposite hand, opposite thigh. Turn and look at the back. Coming into a gentle twist. Staying here for five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, arms up above the head, lengthening your spine. Exhale, twist. Opposite hand, opposite thigh. The other hand is behind your spine, wrapped around your waist. Keep turning, overlooking your shoulder, look at the back. Turning the neck as well. Staying here for five, four, three, two, one. Slowly come back to center. Don't let go of the front hand. Inhale, the other arm up, forming a crescent, looking up. Slowly, slowly curl back down. Hands on your thighs. Coming into torso turn, starting out a small circle. Gradually do a deeper and deeper torso turn. Moving your shoulders as well. Warming up the spine. when you're in the center position, go the other way, reverse. And we're gonna slowly, slowly come back to center to release. Now go into the boat pose. Get the fleshy part out from your butt. Bend both knees, hands underneath the kneecap. Coming up on your tippy toes. When you're ready, lift your feet off the ground. Don't lean back too much. First round can be support. Staying here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, slowly release, come down, get your breath. Another round when you're ready. Set yourself up, lift your feet off the ground. You can continue to hold on this way or this way. If you're ready for the next level, let go. Staying here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly release, very good. Catch a breath. One last round to go when you're ready. Left, off. Don't lean back too much. You can continue to hold on or let go, or we can roll the boat for 10, 9, 8, toss and turn as well, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, very good. Slowly, slowly release. Bounce it up. And we're going to count well on the strap again. So I'm using medium, so have different weights just in case you want to switch up or switch down. Come lie down your side. Bring the strap around. Go around the thigh. Come lie down the side. Make yourself comfortable. So clamshell, open, shut. I'm using the medium weight. It has some resistance, but I don't feel that I'm going to have a really challenging workout. So we're just going to do a few more repetitions. Slowly release, and I'm going to move it down. I'm going to pass it up. Now, if this is too far down, I'm going to move it a little bit further around my calf. Now, you may find that the range of motion is not very much, so I'm just weak. Gonna just pulse it up and down. Flex your feet. Feel the burn. Five, four, three, two, one, slowly, slowly release and go to the other side. Just gonna go lie down the other side. So I'm gonna move it up to my 5, and we're going to do it in clamshell first. So take your time to set up. No need to rush. Glue the feet together. Make sure you set a spot that is comfortable. And when you're ready, we're going to go open, shut. Glue the feet together. Clamshell. Few more reps. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stay here. Staying here for another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly release. If you need to pat it out, make a hammer with your feet, with your fist, and pat, pat, pat to release any tension that you may have. Now we're gonna move it a little bit further down to the calf area. Make sure it's in the right spot. So take your time to set up. We're gonna pulse it up and down. Flex your feet. Feel how tight it is. Even the glutes area, your quadricep, and your calf, all working together in this one. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly release. And we're gonna come lie down on our back. Keep the band with you. We're gonna use it for the bridge pose. We're gonna slide it up. Release your spine down, keeping the natural curve in your lower back, and down by your side. Slightly tuck the chin in to protect your neck. So now we have the band around our thighs. When you're ready, press firmly on the mat. Inhale, come up. Exhale, down. Engage your core abdominal muscles. Quadricep. Are firm, as well as the glutes. Now, if you find that the medium weight is still a little bit too easy for you, you can move it up to the heavy one. So that will be the red one. Strengthening the front abdominal muscles and the lower back muscles. Keeping your spine healthy and strong, especially if you have back pain. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Staying up here, up, up, up on your tippy toes. You can place your hand on your waist to adjust the height of your bridge, coming on your elbows. All the weights in the shoulder, regular weights in the head or neck. Chin is almost touching the chest. Staying up here for 5, 4, 3, 2, four, three, two, one. Release the arm back down by your side. Release the heel back down. One more breath at a time. Release the spine back down. Once you come all the way down, we're going to windshield wiper a few times. Dropping both knee to one side. Let it fall wherever it falls. Make sure the butt stay down. You should feel the stretch here, quadriceps, hip joints. Listen to your body. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, drop them to the other side. Let it fall wherever it falls. But stay down. You should feel the stretch here, quadriceps, hip joints. Slowly, slowly come back to the center. Now, we're going to keep the band on us. Doing a few rounds of leg lift. If you like, move it further down. Just going to try out the difference. When you're ready, slowly lift the legs up to the ceiling. Flex the feet. Staying up here, stretching our hamstrings. Let the blood circulate back to your heart, helping you with circulation. When you're ready, we're gonna lift the hand chest up, opposite hand, opposite foot. We're using the core abdominal muscles. Don't use your neck muscles. Neck, shoulders, upper back, arm relax. Let's do another five, four, three, two, one. Holding on to the big toes or any part of the legs. Keeping your upper body up. Continue to stretch hamstring. Staying here for five, four, three, two, one. Slowly release the head down, up, down by your side. And we're going to do our helicopter legs with the band. So we do have to engage the legs so that the band is not going to fall off. Smaller circle. As you wind your leg down, bigger and bigger circle, and still engaging the legs so that the band is not going to fall off. And we're going to reverse the rotation. Engaging your legs, your abdominal muscles. Slowly, slowly come back to center. If you need to adjust the band, go ahead. We're gonna do three rounds of leg lift. Catch your breath here. Lower down for seven, six, five, four, three, two, don't drop it, bend both knees, lifting the legs back up. Catch your breath here, second round, lower down for seven, six, five, four, three, two, don't drop it, bend both knees, lifting the legs back up. Take a breath here, last round, lower down for seven, six, five, four, three, two. When your legs are 1 foot off the ground, don't drop it. Staying here. Feel how tight it is in your quadricep. Your core is strong. Staying here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly release everything down. Bounce it a few times. We're gonna have one leg up, one leg down. Because we have the band around us, we can only go up so high. Go to where you feel the resistance. Toes are pointing up to the ceiling. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly release. And you can remove the band, put it aside. Gonna go into a bicycle and then by your side, lift your knee up. You can ride high bicycle, low bicycle, your choice. Extend the leg. Engage your core abdominal muscles. Nice and slow of control. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly release. Wrap your arms around your knees. Rocking side to side. Coming into a big circular motion if you like. Covering a big area. And reverse. Slowly, slowly come back to center and release. Bounce it a few times. When releasing on the right side, wrap your arms around the right knee. Draw it close to your chest or armpit. Gently pump it a few times. Inhale, relax the grip. Exhale, squeeze. Massaging the organs on the right side as well as ascending cobra. Slowly come back to center, lifting the head chest up, head to knee, lifting the left leg off the mat. If you'd like to grab a hold of the right foot, go ahead. More intensity here. Slowly release the head and the straight leg. And now we come to a spinal twist, right foot on left thigh. Opposite hand, opposite thigh, right arm out shoulder height, palm facing up, palm or palm facing down. Doesn't matter. Shoulders and shoulder blades are still on the mat. Turn and look at the right side if your neck is good. Stretch, strengthen and tone the lower back muscles. Keeping your spine healthy and strong. One more breath, and we're gonna slowly bring everything back to the center. Straighten out the legs, bounce it a few times. Repeat on the other side. When releasing, wrap your arms around the left knee. Draw it close to the chest or armpit. Gently pump it a few times. Inhale, relax the grip, exhale, squeeze. Massaging organs on the left side as well as descending colon. Helping you to digest, detox.
Lifting the head, chest up, head to knee, lifting the right leg off the mat, squeeze. If you can grab hold of the left foot, go ahead. More intensity here. Slowly release the head and the straight leg. And now we come to spinal twist. Opposite hand, opposite thigh. Left arm on shoulder height. If you have room to extend the top leg, go ahead. Shoulders, shoulder blades are still on the mat. Turn and look at the left side, your neck is good. Stretching our lower back muscles. Creating spaces between L4 and L5. Helping you to relieve back pain. One more breath here. We're going to slowly bring everything back to the center. Straighten out the legs. Bounce it a few times. Coming into a happy baby. Bend your knees. Lift your feet off the ground. If you can touch the bottom of your feet, go ahead. Inner arch, outer arch. Holding onto your big toes or any part of the legs. Press down so that the knees are close to the armpit. Rocking side to side. Massaging the entire spine and entire back. Opening up hip joint. Slowly come back to center, open up your legs in a big V. Continue to rock side to side, stretching out the inner thighs. Slowly come back to center, lifting the head, chest up, keep your legs open in a big V. Place the hand through the opening between the legs, lifting the head, chest up, and we're gonna pass it up and down here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly release the head down, and we're gonna scissor the legs here, one time in front, one time behind. You don't have to open up wide, and you don't have to go fast. Nice and slow, with control. Let's do another 5, 4, 3, 2, and one last one. Bring the legs together with control. We're going to release the legs back down on the mat using abdominal muscles. Once you come all the way down, bounce it a few times. Bring the sole of your feet together. Let the knee fall to form a diamond shape. Release the spine down, keeping the natural curve in your lower back and down on the side. Palm facing down. Close your eyes for a moment. Leg gravity does its job to open up the hip joint. Now we're going to slowly bring the knees together, drop them to the right side. Reach your right arm, roll over to the right side, coming into a fetus position on your side. When you're ready, use your top arm to push yourself up. Coming into a comfortable seated position. Sitting up nice and tall. Inhale your arms up. Turn the palm out, exhale down. Deep, deep inhale through your nose and deep, deep exhale through your nose as well. One last one. Bring your hands to heart center. Thank you very much for watching, sharing your positive energy with all of us and letting me guide you through this practice. Always my pleasure. Namaste.